President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. continues in his quest to make the Philippines an investment hub. Speaking at the World Economic Forum Country Roundtable at the Palace, Marcos touted the country's robust economic growth and the reforms that his administration has made to improve ease of doing business in the country. This as he invited participants to invest in flagship infrastructure projects or through the Maharlika Investment Fund.
Our economic liberalization measures signal the dawn of a new era of investments here in the Philippines. Now, international firms are welcome to invest in a wider range of high-impact sectors, form joint ventures with Filipinos, or even fully own domestic enterprises in select renewable energy projects. We aim to cover every front at every point of your investment journey. Clearly, the Philippines is in a prime position to enter into a sustained period of robust economic expansion over the next couple of years. I extend an invitation to our guests and partners to join us in this exciting new phase.
The WEF Country Roundtable brings together some 50 local and international firms and organizations to explore investment opportunities. According to the Palace, participants include representatives from Google and LinkedIn. Washington's top diplomat reaffirms ironclad defense and economic ties between the Philippines and the U.S. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken met with President Marcos Jr. Tuesday. Blinken assured Marcos the Biden's administration's commitment to the Philippines is more than rock solid across various sectors.
I think that new horizon of cooperation is also incredibly promising. But it's building on the very strong foundation in our countries where we have the same priorities, whether it's economic development, whether it's dealing with climate change, with food security, of course, upholding international law, our commitment to the Indo-Pacific writ large, and to the relationship, the alliance between the United States and the Philippines in particular, is more than rock solid.
Blinken's visit comes ahead of plans for U.S. President Joe Biden to host Marcos and Japanese Prime Minister Fumio Kishida in April. The leaders are expected to discuss goals for a free and open Indo-Pacific, as well as economic growth, clean energy, and climate cooperation. Blinken says the summit will also tackle increasing the country's cooperation on semiconductors.
We're constantly expanding this partnership to meet bigger challenges, to seize bigger opportunities, including semiconductors. If you look at what the Philippines is doing in this area, it's already extraordinary. The Philippines has about 20% of the global market for assembly, for testing, and for packaging. And of course, it's a big part of the Philippines economy, representing about 12% of its GDP. But we want to support Filipino manufacturing, decrease dependencies, strengthen global supply chains, and to double the number of semiconductor factories here in the Philippines. And we're exploring, as you heard, opportunities through the growth and investment, global investment and infrastructure program.
Here are some local corporate headlines. Bloomberry Resorts and its two units agreed to a universal settlement of their dispute with Global Gaming Asset Management, or GGAM. This stems from a 2013 case, where Enrique Razon terminated a management contract with GGAM for the Soler Resort and Casino. The settlement requires Bloomberry Unit Sureste Properties to buy the 921 million Bloom shares held by GGAM for a total purchase price of $300 million. In the earnings stream, DM Wenceslao more than tripled its 2023 bottom line to 7.3 billion pesos. The Asiana developer attributes this growth to robust leasing, stable residential growth, and one-time gains amounting to 5.5 billion pesos from the consolidation of a joint venture entity. And finally, Del Monte Pacific posts a net loss of $29 million in the third quarter of its fiscal year 2024. The company says sales slipped on lower U.S., Philippines, and packaged export sales, which offset a 17% growth in fresh exports. This brings its nine-month net loss to $51 million, a reversal from its $29 million profit from the same period last year.